Good day, I'm Dave Olson from HootSuite here with a community nugget. Today we're going to talk about crowdsourcing and how you can use crowdsourcing to complete projects, whether for your professional gigs, for your nonprofit groups, or your hobby group, or anything else you have in mind. Now, crowdsourcing has some negative connotations. It's just a way to get people to do stuff for you for free, or that the results aren't very good. But here at HootSuite over the last few years, we've used crowdsourcing tactics for all sorts of different projects with great success. And along the way, we've learned some great tips that will help you inspire and motivate your audience for best results. So come along, won't you?
You should be kissed and offered by someone who knows how.
And I suppose you think you're the proper person?
If crowdsourcing had a patron saint, I think it would be Tom Sawyer from Mark Twain's classic novel. There's a story in there where Tom Sawyer gets in a little bit of trouble and he has to go out and whitewash the fence. Instead of doing it himself, which would have taken up the whole afternoon and killed his fishing trip, he recruited his buddies by inspiring them, cajoling, maybe manipulating just a little bit, but mostly inspiring their participation in order to help get that fence painted quickly and even better than he could have done it himself. And really, this is a great model to think about for crowdsourcing projects. The first thing that I would recommend is go in with a clear mandate and timeline. Sometimes when you go out and recruit volunteers and you have this kind of vague notion and this big, giant problem to solve, it seems like boiling the ocean. Instead, drill this down into tactical tasks with a clear mandate and a clear timeline. I kind of think of this as being a bus driver. You know, when the bus picks you up, there's a sign out front that says exactly where they're going, and you trust that bus driver to take you carefully where you need to go. You as a community manager and running this project have to kind of take that same tactic, let the folks know where we're going, i.e. we're going to translate Hootsuite into Russian, we're going to raise this much money for Sing It Forward campaign. Whatever it is that you're going to do, that's your sign on the front of the bus. Then you give them a timeline, the same way as a bus has a schedule. That's not always exactly right, but you kind of got to keep this project on a schedule because that way you have wins that you can celebrate. If it takes 3 years to complete a project, well, people are going to drop off because they're going to get demotivated. But if you can have clear, accessible goals along the way, milestones, so to speak, you're going to keep that community inspired and keep things moving along. The next suggestion is inspire and incentivize your volunteers. Now, really your job becomes, rather than going in there and doing the work, is managing and inspiring these people. And to start doing that, you need to get to know these folks. What makes them excited? And then you need to model your behavior to show that, well, I'm in this with you. Now, incentives are really tricky because if you start turning this into do this and we'll give you that, if it's money or something, they're going to reach that goal and then they're going to take off. Instead, you want to teach them how to dream of the sea rather than build a ship, to make a metaphor there. What this means is get the people who are going to be inspired by the big picture. You know, people intrinsically, for the most part, want to be part of something bigger, something that feels like they're effectuating positive change in the world somehow. So inspire them to that end and incent them with things that are unique but not necessarily expensive. In our case, we send out little special envelopes of stickers and pins and tattoos or t-shirts or scarves to say thanks. The next thing I'd recommend is kind of builds on top of that, which is turning your volunteers into stars. Whenever we release a new language, for example, with Hootsuite, which the whole Hootsuite translation project has been 95% crowdsourced, we name check all the people who were their key contributors to this translation project. In some cases, the folks from the Chinese Translate-a-thon, they got a unique gift for coming down and helping us out in that they got to make their own Hootsuite Translate-a-thon tote bag and their own custom Hoot kits. Now, this seems a little cheesy in some ways because it's not a high-cost thing, but it's really about that sign of participation. If any of you have been to summer camp or been on a sports team, it's those little trinkets that help you remember that experience that you had together with other people that really make that engaging. So you really just got to figure out what can inspire and incent these people, and then work hard to turn these people into stars. You know, in our case, a lot of these volunteers are social media enthusiasts in different countries, and they don't necessarily have a lot of folks around them that are excited about this. And these folks have found this, found Twitter in general or Facebook or Hootsuite specifically, and they want to share this story with all the people in their community. Help them do that and help position them as one of those taste-making users, and they will be a lot more happy and you will have a motivated person. Now, how to share this momentum? personally, I think is really important in order to keep the momentum going to frequently share the successes. Now, this can come in terms of updates through a Twitter account. This can come through newsletters, blog posts, but be constantly sharing this story because then people can feel ownership of this a little bit. We've reached this threshold of that much fundraising. We've now translated this many documents. We've now contributed that much knowledge to this educational resource. Whatever it is, share those milestones and share them loudly and share them frequently. By doing so, again, you're going to keep the people motivated and you're going to have this story spreading wider and wider where other people are going to want to come and jump on board. You know, and this kind of goes to our next tip, which is modeling behavior in order to inspire. If people see that you're right in the trenches with them and you're participating alongside of them and you're working hard by getting to know them and sharing the stories that they care about, they're going to realize that this is a reciprocal relationship. This isn't us asking you to do this and while we sit over here and relax and have a cup of tea. No, this is you rolling up your sleeves and getting right down in there and really getting to know these people. And by modeling this behavior and sharing their stories, like whenever we talk about Vitaly Murkalov in Irkutsk, Siberia, Russia, it's so exciting because then all these people in other parts of the world go, well, geez, Vitaly's doing it in Irkutsk. I can do this in Turkey or Indonesia or Austin, Texas or Vancouver, Canada. It doesn't really matter, but you find these people who are the stars, share their story, and then you're going to model that behavior to recruit more and more people. So with all these tips, you put these together and you're going to build these relationships that are not manipulative. And that's really important. The other thing that's super important is ensure a high standard of quality with all these projects. This kind of comes back to putting out that clear mandate and that clear expectation of what it is that we're all trying to accomplish together. You put this together and you're going to have a happy community, and whatever your goal is, you're more likely to reach it faster and faster. So I'm Dave Olson, and we love sharing these community tips here from HootSuite. There's more community nuggets coming, and you can always hit us up at Hoot Club or find more stuff at the HootSource blog.
And another thing, those pantalets. I don't know a woman in Paris who wears pantalets anymore.
What do they? You shouldn't talk about such things.